Okay, welcome to another video of 2 kilobyte of fun. Today I'm going to prepare this Lumia 930, also known as the Icon in the United States, for Doomsday. Next week, December 16th, Microsoft will pull the plug on the Windows 8 store, and after that moment you won't be able to easily install any applications on your Windows 8 phones. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give this phone a factory reset. I will make a new account for it, especially for this phone. I'm going to fill the phone with as much applications as possible, and I will also include the Windows upgrade program, so you can upgrade it to Windows 10 if you would like that later on. Because some phones can be upgraded to Windows 10, and the Windows 10 store will be available for some time to come. Before we get started, make sure you have a backup of all your personal data on the phone, because everything will be wiped in this process. I'm going to show you what to do if you give the phone a factory reset, but in some occasions you might want to install a different firmware first. For example, this one came with the magenta T-Mobile logo up front and I didn't like it, so I flashed it with an unbranded Dutch firmware. I will not show that in this video, but I will give the instructions below in the description of this video. One question before we get started: what Windows Phone version do you want to run on your Lumia? You could either choose Windows Phone 8.1, or you could choose to upgrade to Windows Phone 10. What is good to choose? If you have one of the older models, there's not much to choose. But make sure that all the applications are up to date. For example, if you have a 1020 and you have a factory reset one, but you didn't upgrade to Lumia camera, the camera is basically useless. So if you plan to buy a 1020, make sure the seller doesn't give it a factory reset after December 16th, because then you basically destroy its camera. If you have one of the very, very popular models, the 640 and the 640 XL, which can be upgraded to Windows Phone 10, I would still suggest you to keep it at Windows Phone 8.1, because these models are very, very well suited for car navigation. If you do car navigation, you want to have an IPS display and not an OLED, because that burns in. And the memory is not that big on this one, but you can put in an SD card, and so you can easily load all the maps that are available, and you could have a very, very well prepared offline navigation tool that is up to all the latest road modifications right now, today. So yeah, if you consider having a dedicated car navigation, get an old Lumia 640 XL and you're basically set for like 20, 30 euros with an excellent navigation device, which is also capable of playing very, very nice selection of games for the kids in the car. Do you have one of the old flagships, the 930 and the 1520? Then you can consider upgrading to Windows Phone 10. I'm going to install Windows Phone 8.1 on this first. I will install all the upgrades for Windows Phone 8.1, and after that I will give it an upgrade to Windows Phone 10, so you can see that as well. Okay, let's get started with the factory reset. Choose the language. You get an error about no SIM being found. So accept. This is one of the nasty sides of Windows Phone, all the telemetry. So you have to set the date. If you don't set the date correctly, you will get all kind of certificate errors when trying to upgrade. I will choose later. Right now it's installing all applications that are in the factory reset. This will take quite some time. Okay, a couple of minutes later, apps are installed. We go next, next. Okay, we don't want to take part in that. So this is a fresh installed Lumia 930. It asks to reboot. I'm going to settings and I'm going to connect to Wi-Fi. And now I'm going to set up the store. Okay, after this first setup, we have to make a Microsoft account. Because I had this decent collection of Lumia phones, I had to do this procedure at least 15 times. And I was running into some problems with the Microsoft account server. And there's a limit on how many you can make on a day, so I had to use a couple of phones with different IP addresses. So I was able to set up 15 different accounts for all my phones I showed in the previous video. I would advise not to use one account on different phones, because if you want to sell one of the phones, that account kind of sucks in all the personal data and it's not very handy to sell it. But if you make a unique account for it, you can sell it with that account and you can transfer the ownership of the account. Right now it says connect, and I'm going to make an account. Okay. Okay, now it asks a phone number. Okay, you can verify it, but you can also choose to say, I can't do this right now. And I found out that that works pretty well. Now the store is set up, we can download all the updates for the various programs and the operating system itself. So we can upgrade it to Windows Phone 8.1 Denim, the latest version that was available. Update everything. So go to settings and choose automatically update, because otherwise you have to click a couple of times that you want to download, and now it's going to download everything at once. Sometimes you get a reboot. Sometimes we need to give permissions. Okay, let's have a look at here drive. Okay. Just begin, downloading Dutch voice, okay, download maps, in the meanwhile the download's near the end. Default applications are updated. Now I'm going to this one, phone updates. Okay, this is for speech. I'm going to install English. Okay. Update to download. This is probably the update to the latest 8.1 Denim version. If you see the gears, then it's a real operating system update. Okay, now here we go to popular free apps. A couple of recommendations from my side on the applications to install. Telegram will continue to work after January 1st when WhatsApp will stop. You can install applications for like running, like run the map. It will allow you to track your runs, but also export generic GPX files so you can process your running data with all other applications available. I like Cute Soma for listening to music. It's a San Francisco based free music broadcaster. It's very nice. Sequencer is a nice program to create quick sketches of music and beats on. Cast Classic is the application I use for podcasts. Of course, you have to upgrade Lumia camera to the latest version to have all the features of your camera available, like raw image storage. PDF reader is a good one for Windows 8.1 because there's no PDF reader included. And consider installing a couple of games like Minecraft or the real Minecraft, Crossy Road, some speedrunner games. There's tons of stuff available for everybody's liking. I'm going to add Lumia Selfie, which is quite fun. Okay, and then you go back. You can add Spotify. Go back. Lumia Camera, important one. Ah, that's already on there. If you have a Windows Phone running 8.1 and that is eligible to upgrade to Windows Phone 10, you should install the Windows Phone Upgrade Assistant. I will show that. Be aware that if you upgrade to Windows Phone 10, that hair drive is not working any longer. And Netflix. PDF reader. Office Lens is very nice. File Manager is nice to have. Stopwatch is always nice to have. Windows Insider, small tool but might be useful. Telegram. Okay, what else is there? You see that a couple of apps that were previously asking money are now for free. This one's also nice for YouTube. You can decide later on. This one I like. This one's useful in the Netherlands. Rain radar app. Yeah, you should really check out what you like. There's lots of stuff. Now I'm going to the games. To search Minecraft. As you can see, you can download the full Minecraft version. I'm going to do that later on. I have to add a billing account. So it's still installing all the stuff. Okay, one more important thing is to include some extra languages. Okay, now it's going to download all the keyboards. You will get a phone update if you install extra keyboards. Okay, another update. They keep coming. This has to do with all the keyboards that I downloaded. So each time a new keyboard is added, it needs to reboot. I don't know why, but a little bit cumbersome. All the keyboards are installed. Okay, so this is basically a fully updated Lumia phone. Okay, now I'm going to upgrade this even further to Windows Phone 10. So we go to the Windows Upgrade Assistant. Next, checking if this one can be upgraded. Okay, it's available. So you have to check that. Okay, it's ready. Now it says update is available and we can download the upgrade to Windows 10. This will take some time, it's a pretty large download. Okay, this one is almost ready. And now it's preparing the installation, will take some other time. Okay, this one will continue installing, it will get more updates afterwards. Since this phone has come beyond the December 16th point of doom, it kind of goes out of the scope of this video. Okay, this was my advice on how to upgrade your Windows Phone for Doomsday next week. Okay, please be very kind to your Windows Phone. If you have a nice specimen and if you want to make someone else happy with it, take these precautions I showed in this video and never hit that factory reset button ever again. And if Microsoft is watching this, I would really like if you keep the store open. I think it's not very difficult to keep it open. You have it open anyway and you have the account system still working and running because people buy for Windows desktop and for Windows 10 mobile. So the account part is not the problem. And it would also be nice to keep this history available in the future. I mean, Apple is doing very well in preserving old documentation and installation software for all their previous models. So learn from them and keep some things alive. Please, please make one more effort for Windows Phone and give us an offline deployment tool so we can get applications from all the repositories that are kept up by fans and sideload applications in the future after Doomsday. Thank you very much for watching. There are two videos on the way as well. One is the second part of the history of Windows phones by Nokia and Microsoft. And the second one is a video about the magnificent cameras that are in especially the 1020 and the 950 XL, which are still astonishing today. Thanks for watching. Please hit the subscribe button and the bell button if you want to have instant notifications on the new Windows Phone videos or any of my other vintage gear videos.